Parameters are really powerful tools in Tableau. Let's take a look at how we can use a parameter to control last n days in a chart. Alright, now that we're in Tableau Desktop, let's take a look at how to use a parameter to control last n days. I have a new sheet here just called Last N Days. I'm going to build a simple line chart first using date and sales. Just double clicked on date and double clicked on sales to bring them into the view. And if I drag sales up to rows, it gives me a line chart by default. I'm going to change it from year to week number, give us a couple more marks to work with. Simple line chart, and the use case that we're talking about here is maybe a user doesn't want to see all of the chart. They only want to see a certain number of days back. My chart now goes from January 6th all the way until February 26th, 2022, to December 25th, 2022. So I'm going to create a parameter. It's going to be an integer first. So if I click this drop down here, create parameter, I get my create parameter pane. I'm just going to call it last n. I'm going to give it a value of 365. Let's say 365 days is going to be your default. And change it to an integer, although a float would have worked as well. And the user can choose whatever number they want, so allow values to be all. I'm going to add my parameter to the view by clicking on the parameter dropdown in the parameters pane and show parameter. Of course, parameters don't do anything until you connect them to your view. So I can change this to 300, it's not doing anything. Click this drop down to create a calculated field. I'm going to create a boolean, so a true or false, a yes or no value, true or false, I guess not yes or no. So create calculated field. I'm going to call this in range and zoom in a little bit. I just need to do a test. So I need to test if the date is greater than 300 days back, n days, so my 300 value. So I'm going to test if date is greater than or equal to 'today', just as a starting point. So this is testing if date is greater than or equal to 'today', but I need to adjust 'today' back to be 300 days ago. And the today function is just like it sounds, just like it looks, it's just grabbing today's date, which is October 14th, 2022. If I wrap today with a date add function, so I'm gonna type date add, put an open parenthesis. I'm gonna add a number of days, so I want to put a string value of day, comma, negative, I'm going to drag in my last n parameter. So negative last n days. Add another comma, and then we have today. I'm going to close that out and just read that back here for a second. I'm subtracting 300 days from today, and I'm testing if the date is greater than that date. Yes or no, true or false. Click apply and okay. And if I grab this in range and just put it on color to begin with, you can see if I show the color here, that true is orange and blue is false. So all of these days right here are greater than 300 days ago, and all of the days in blue are less than 300 days ago. Click OK. And let's just take a copy of in range, so I can hold the control key down or command key down. put in range onto filters, and I only want true values. Click apply, okay, and I have a line chart of everything in the last 300 days. Since my data has future data in it, I might want to add to it. So this is going all the way to December 25th, 2022, which hasn't happened yet. So I'm actually going to adjust my in-range calculation. I'm going to add a little bit of logic to the if statement. To the statement, I guess it's not an if. So I'm going to test that date is greater than or equal to 300 days ago. Let's zoom in so we can see it. And date is less than or equal to today. And that's going to filter out your future values. You might not have them in your case, but you know, as a kind of a rule of thumb that I have, I always, when I'm doing in-range calculations, I always test if the date is less than today as well. Click apply, and we only have the last 300 days. Change it to 200, and it adjusts to 200.